pasó aquí en Auto 060 en la edición de esta semana. Ya tuvimos ahí la espectacular presentación del Toyota Corolla en California. Y now we're going to switch to English because we have Paul Button, past president of Southern Automotive Media Association. How are you, Paul?
Fine, Javier, how are you?
Excellent, thank you. Thank you for taking the time to talk to us here. And so we're talking about topless in Miami, and still some people get confused with the title, but it's nothing about fashion or like going to Miami Beach, but about convertibles. So, and Paul was in charge of the boating. Somebody was supposed to help him with that, but he wasn't there, right?
Yes, but I forgive him. He had a good reason.
Yeah, as I was saying, I had to go to California for the global presentation of the Toyota Corolla, which was a spectacular. We just talked about in the past segment about that. So, but let's get to the business here. Third year about topless in Miami, and it's been a better and better success every year.
This has been our third year. I believe we had 50 some odd members show up the first year and closer to 70 the second year, and this year we had 72 take part.
That's incredible. I mean, it's really a fun event, and the other lucky thing was that the weather cooperated last week. It was raining a lot here in Miami, and then I just cleared up for it, because talking about convertibles, you want to open the roof.
That is absolutely right, and you're correct about the weather. Of course, I was a little concerned. It was cloudy earlier in the week and cloudy on Wednesday. We had a cloudy and off and on kind of day, and everything was dry until right after we took final pictures of all the winners and got them in, and then the deluge.
Yeah. Excellent. Yeah, so the way this works is that all the members from Southern Automotive Media Association, SAMA, go to Key Biscayne and test drive all the cars this year. Were what, 19 cars from 17 manufacturers, right?
No, we have 17 from 14 manufacturers.
Okay.
A couple who had multiple entries there. We've had, we were supposed to have 18, but the new Bentley there, it was wrecked the week before.
Okay.
We had a little problem with it.
Yes, for the record, it wasn't me. I'm not involved with that one, too.
I can't imagine what that guy's going through now.
Exactly. So let's go. We have six categories. Overall category was won by the Porsche 911 Carrera 4S Cabriolet. Really a fantastic car. I always have said that when people ask me about, we all drive new cars all the time, but this is one of my, probably the best, my favorite car.
It was really, it's really spectacular, really a great car. And its performance, looks, everything about it is really just unbelievable.
Yeah, that, I mean, obviously this is not a competition about performance and all that, but that car has really a great engine, a lot of horsepower, and that fantastic PDK transmission with double clutch. So technologically, it's very advanced, but also the looks of it. The one that won, we just have posted the link to Facebook and our Facebook page. A dark blue color with black wheels, and so it was very, very nice.
Yes, that is true. And there are, by the way, you can tell your listeners they can go to the website toplessinmiami.com and they won't get in trouble.
Yeah, you can actually watch to it at home. So the other category, which the Porsche was there, the exotic convertible, right?
We had a new category this year. We had the exotic luxury convertible. That was the Jaguar XKR, which had won the luxury category the year before.
Yeah, and what other cars were in this category?
Well, of course, the Porsche was in the category, and the Mercedes-Benz SLS, which had won convertible of the year last year, was in that category.
Yeah, very tough category, because, I mean, all the cars are fantastic, and it's just like, as we were saying, it's not a performance competition, it's more like, how does the convertible work? I mean, what the performance actually opening it and opening down and closing it down, and so those kind of things, right? That's the criteria for voting?
Yes, you're right. It is a very tough competition. That's probably, well, actually, all the categories are pretty tough to score, but the competition seems to be getting closer and closer as the automakers really, throughout the whole the automotive world, increase the quality of their products.
Yeah. So then, so the exotic category, that was said, and then the luxury category, another tough one, because there's some very good cars in that segment.
Javier, I'm sorry, but I'm having trouble hearing you.
Yeah, no, I was saying that the next category is the luxury.
Oh, yes, the luxury.
Very, very tough, too.
Yes, somebody wondered what the difference between the exotics were all six figures.
Okay.
So that was the difference there. Yeah, the BMW M3, this was the first year that, I take it back, this was the second year BMW was in. They were in the first year. I don't believe they had anybody in there last year. The M3 won out. There was, boy, talk about a lineup. The M3, the Audi A5, the Infiniti D37 IPL, and the Mercedes-Benz E-Class. I mean, you could put those in a hat and draw the name, and you'd have a worthy winner.
Yeah, people would be lucky to just drive one of them, any of them, really. But so it was a close call, I guess, right?
Yes, it was. All the competition was pretty close. And in the next category, where the full-size convertible, the Chrysler 200, stepped up there. A lot of people noted the improvement that has made over the BMW 135 and the Jeep Wrangler. That was only three cars in that category, but that's been a category that we have kind of filled around with. It's basically made up of cars that are below the luxury class but still seat four people, at least four people.
Yeah, and that's some of the criteria to put above the list of candidates because, I mean, you have, as you mentioned with the exotics, they have to be over 100,000 for the basic price, and then you got the luxury, and then you have these full-size convertibles. And this is another example of how Chrysler has improved in recent years. I mean, the 200, to be honest, when they first introduced it, wasn't that good. But they have improved a lot.
Yes. There's a big difference between that and the Sebring that it replaced, and they're in a lot of huge difference.
Yeah. And then you have the performance convertibles, another tough category in which the Nissan 370Z Roadster won.
That has been one of my personal favorites since it was introduced about, I guess, 10, 11 years ago now when it was brought back.
Yeah.
It has been really a steady performer for Nissan. The other two entrants in that were the Chevrolet Camaro, which won the family car last year, and we moved that into the performance. And
yeah, I think it's six better fit there, I believe.
Now, the Camaro fits a little better in performance.
Yeah. And then a repeat, a three-peat for the Fiat Abarth. I mean, not for the same exact car, but Fiat has won every single year in this Topless in Miami competition by Southern Automotive Media Association. The third consecutive year that Fiat has won in the compact category for convertibles. That's an amazing car, really.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting. Every they came out with the basic 500C, which won it the first year. Last year, I believe it was the Gucci edition. This year, it's the Abarth Cabrio, and your listeners might be familiar with that from the advertisements with Charlie Sheen running around through that mansion there. It's really a lot of performance. You could almost move that to the performance category.
Oh, absolutely. Yes, you're right about that. And to be fair with other manufacturers, like, these are the cars that came to the competition. I mean, as you mentioned, the Bentley was wrecked in Boston, I believe, so he couldn't show up. So these are the cars that come to the show. So, like, for next year, any other manufacturer wants their cars to be judged here at the Topless in Miami 2014. I mean, they have to bring their cars, right?
Right. We put out a notice in January, early February, late January, that that we're having the event. We may not have the exact date by then, but we always know when we're looking for it, and we give them the opportunity to enter any cars and models that they want. We also give them the opportunity to say, hey, we wanted it in this class and or that particular category, and if we think it fits there, we'll leave it there. So they have the opportunity. We had We had 14 manufacturers this year.
Yeah, there were Mercedes-Benz, Nissan, Infiniti, Jaguar, Porsche, Chevrolet, Chrysler, Ford, Jeep, Audi, Mazda, Fiat, Smart, and Volkswagen. And I'm sure Fiat is going to try to come up with something for next year. I don't think they want to break that streak.
Yeah, I was kidding with the representative, Ariel Gavilan, who was there the other night. I was kidding. I said, well, I guess we're going to have to name the trophy after Fiat.
Yeah, that's fun. So we're talking to Paul Borden, past president of Southern Automotive Media Association, and who was in charge of the judging here for Topless in Miami 2013, which took place in Key Biscayne last week. And again, we have posted the whole list of winners on our webpage, so you can check in that. So, and there's also toplessinmiami.com. Right, Paul?
That's correct.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and I promise to match my schedule a little bit better next year so I can be of any help next year, hopefully.
Well, you were missed, my man. I'm sorry you couldn't make it.
Thank you very much, Paul. Thank you for that. And again, toplessinmiami.com. Go and visit SAMA, Southern Automotive Media Association. A great event, and I'm sure other associations around the country are looking at it, but they don't have our weather or our luxury paradise here in Miami.
I know, we're lucky there. Thank you a lot.
Yeah, thank you. Have a good day. So ahí fue Topless in Miami, la competencia de los mejores convertibles del 2013. Y como decíamos ahí en inglés en la entrevista con Paul Boren, no es que sean los únicos, sino que son los autos que algunos fabricantes, en este caso 14 fabricantes, enviaron sus modelos para participar en esta edición de Topless in Miami 2013, la tercera edición. El Fiat ganó por tercero año consecutivo en la categoría del convertible compacto, y el ganador general de la competencia fue el Porsche 911 Carrera 4S Cabriolet, un auto súper magnífico. En el convertible exótico, el Jaguar XKR. En el convertible de lujo, el BMW M3. En el full-size convertible, el Chrysler 200 Limited. Y en el convertible deportivo, el Nissan 370 Roadster Tour. Un evento realmente muy bueno y seguramente se va a repetir por muchos años. Y esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota, y antes que me olvide, gracias a DJ Kappa y en los controles, regresamos aquí para otra prueba de manejo con el Smart Electric, también aquí por las calles de Miami.